Thanks for tuning in again and welcome back to Deep Learning. In this video, we want to talk about the organizational matters if you want to obtain the certificate, and we want to conclude the introduction. So looking forward to a couple of exciting minutes on the topic of deep learning. So let's have a look at the organizational matters. Now, the module consists of 5 ECTS. This is the lecture plus exercises. So it's not just sufficient to watch all of those videos. You have to pass the exercises. In the exercises, you will implement everything that we are talking about here, also in Python. We will start from scratch. So we will need to implement perceptrons, neural networks, backpropagation, up to deep learning. In the very end, we will even move ahead towards GPUs and also large deep learning frameworks.
You know, if you're a development engineer, or if you're, if you have the development build like I do, then you can see, all the debug information. But those would just be like total gibberish to most people.
Right. So this is a mandatory part, and it's not just sufficient to pass the written exam. The content of the exercise is Python. You will do an introduction to Python if you have never used it, because Python is one of the main languages that are used in deep learning implementations today. You will really develop a neural network from scratch. There will be feed-forward neural networks. There will be convolutional neural networks. You will look into regularization techniques, how you can adjust the weights such that they have specific properties. And you will see how you can beat overfitting with those regularization techniques. Of course, you will also implement recurrent neural networks. Later, we use the Python framework and also go for large-scale classification. So for the exercises, you should bring basic knowledge of Python and NumPy. You should know about linear algebra and very important things,
such as matrix multiplications.
Image processing is a definite plus. You should know how to process images, and of course requirements for this class are actually pattern recognition fundamentals, and you should have attended other lectures of our lab already. If you haven't, you might want to consult additional references to follow this class. We are also providing the recordings of the other classes starting from this semester, by the way. So you should bring passion for coding, and you will have to code quite a bit, but you can also learn quite a bit about coding in Python during the exercises. If you haven't done a lot of programming before this class, you might need quite a bit of time in the exercises. But if you complete the exercises, you will also be able to implement things in deep learning frameworks. And I think this is a very good training. So it's not just theory, but you will also do all these things practically. After this course, you can not just download code from GitHub and run it on your own data, but you will also understand the inner workings of networks, how to write your own layers, and how to extend deep learning algorithms also on a very low level. So pay attention to detail. And if you're not well used to programming, it will cost some additional time. There will be 5 exercises throughout the semester. There are unit tests for all the exercises except the last one. In the last exercise, there will be a PyTorch implementation and you will be facing a challenge. you have to solve image recognition tasks in order to pass the exercise. Deadlines are announced on the respective exercise sessions, but you will have to register for them in our online platform on StudOn. In order to participate in the exercises, you have to be an enrolled student of the Friedrich Alexander University Erlangen-Nuremberg. So this will not be accessible to everybody who is watching these videos on different other sources. We're sorry about that, but we provide some open source training assignments, and I will put the link into the description of this video. So what we've seen in the lecture so far is that deep learning is more and more present in daily life. It's not just a technique that's done in research. We've seen this emerging really into many, many different applications, ranging from speech recognition, image processing, and so on, up to autonomous driving.
In the future, any car that does not have autonomy would be about as useful as a horse. Which is not to say that there's no use, it's just rare and somewhat idiosyncratic if somebody has a horse at this point.
It's a very active area of research. If you're doing this lecture, you have a very good preparation for research projects with our lab, but also for industry and other partners. So typically, students who graduated from this class are very popular with industry partners, with research partners, and so on. So if you manage to pass this class, you will also see that the name deep learning will appear in your transcript of records, and you will see that there is considerable interest in your skills. Okay, so far we looked into the perceptron and its relation to biological neurons. Next time on deep learning, we will actually start with the next lecture block, which means that we will extend the perceptron to a universal function approximator. We will look into gradient-based training algorithms for these models, and then we also look into efficient computation of gradients. Now, if you want to prepare for the written exam, it's good to think of a couple of comprehensive questions. Don't worry, the written exam is new, so we will provide a test exam towards the end of the lecture series here, and you will be able to do this written test exam first. We will also provide the solutions such that you can check whether you were able to answer those questions, and only after that you will be facing this written exam. So first and foremost, of course, use this written exam for preparation, but also have a look at the slides, and we prepared on the end of every lecture block. We have this set of comprehensive questions. This is what I'm showing you right now. And there you can also look at some examples of things that we deem important, but obviously you're supposed to look at all of the slides in order to prepare for the exam. So comprehensive questions may be, what are the six postulates of pattern recognition? What is the perceptron objective function? So yes, you will also to have to look into the math. Can you name three applications successfully being tackled by deep learning? And of course, we have a lot of further reading. So I have sometimes links like the ones that I'm showing here, which I will also post with the video in the description. And of course, if you have questions, then you can ask the tutors in your exercise. You can email me, or if you're watching this on different platforms, you can actually use the comment function and ask your question. So I think this is a very nice feature. And in the previous lecture, also many students have been asking comments either in the StudOn forum, but also directly on YouTube. And I try to reply to them as fast as possible. It may not be the right choice to ask questions one day before the exam. This may be suboptimal. But if you follow the videos, if you follow the lecture, then ask frequently. And we will also organize for the students of FAU question and answer sessions where you can ask about the details of the lecture. So there's many, many different options how to get in contact. We also have quite a few references here for this video. And I know this is too quick to read all of this, but you can either pause the video and then review them. And again, I will post this below in the description of this video. So yeah, I hope you like these videos. You've seen the path that we're going. You also see that I try to highlight things that are important for the exam. And we also will provide many different means in order to prepare yourself for the exam. So thank you very much for watching and looking forward to see you in the next video. Bye bye.